مصاحبه فرماندار هواردین با رادیو خبری گفتگوی سراسری آمریکا 17 فوریه 2012. همزمان با جابجایی 400 تن از مجاهدان اشرف به کمپ لیبرتی، رادیو خبری گفتگوی سراسری آمریکا با هواردین مصاحبه ای را ترتیب داد و از او خواست درباره وضعیت در اشرف توضیح دهد. هواردین درباره مجاهدان اشرف اظهار داشت:
These are people who voluntarily disarmed and who the FBI has screened to make sure none of them are terrorists. So what I'm involved with a number of both Democratic and Republican ex-officials, is trying to get these people off the American terrorist list, which they don't belong on, and which they've been removed from other terrorist lists under threat of law, and our laws, our courts have also told the State Department they didn't belong on the terrorist list, so they can be moved to another country so they don't get killed.
Well, this is really interesting because, of course, America wants to keep its promises. How did you personally get involved in this, Governor Dean?
I got invited to go give a speech to this group, and of course, about a year ago, and I saw them on the terrorist list, so I had a lot of qualms. And then I saw the other people who were speaking, including people like Jim Jones, who was a former security advisor to President Obama, Mike Mukasey, a former federal judge who was the Attorney General under Bush, Tom Ridge, Homeland Security under Bush, who I served with as governor when he was governor of Pennsylvania, now as Vermont, Patrick Kennedy, Bill Richardson, former ambassador to the UN. I thought, well, if these people are all involved in this, this can't be crazy. So I went over there. I met them. I heard their stories. And I just think we ought to keep our promises. And I don't think the United States should have any part of allowing genocide by an army that we trained and armed, which is the Army of Iraq.
Well, Governor, you and Governor and Secretary Tom Ridge are both involved in this. Have you been able to move this at all? Is our government responding?
Well, they are responding, but it's very slow going. There's lots of discussion and negotiation, and of course they respond as late. But today is the day that the first 400 of these folks are supposed to be moving to an interim camp. Now, the problem with the interim camp is it's more like a prison than a camp, but we're very hopeful that the State Department, which I think is beginning to work hard on this problem, will get these folks out of here, and this will be a transit center, which is what it's intended for.
And two questions, just sort of foreign policy questions dealing with this group. How do they relate to the government of Iraq right now, and what is the government of Iran trying to do to them?
Well, the government of Iran is trying to kill them, and unfortunately the government of Iraq essentially works for the government of Iran. They've been in there twice killing. They've killed 47 of them who are unarmed already. So the problem we have here is we're not working with a friendly government. Maliki is not our friend. He is a puppet of the Iranians. And he's a big problem for us, which is, of course, all of which I predicted 8 years ago when I was running for president, is that this would be the end of the Iraq war, which is that we make Iran much stronger, and that's exactly what we've done. Don, I think the bottom line is here, 3,400 unarmed civilians, we disarmed them, we promised to defend them, we gave our word, are signed by our military commanders, we've already vetted them, we know none of them are terrorists, and we've got to, this is part of the deal.